In order to calculate the answer to this question, instead of doing it by hand, I'm going to let Python do the work. What I've done is I've collected together the data from the question, the total time of the round trip for the data, which was 75 milliseconds, the one-way distance, which was 2,500 kilometres, the speed of light in an optic fibre, which is 200,000 kilometres per second. Now, note that this is kilometres per second, but the total time is in milliseconds, which means I'm going to need a conversion between milliseconds and seconds. Let's think, what do I need to calculate? Well, what I want to know is the total time at routers. Working backwards from what I want to know, let's see what I need to calculate. Well, the total time spent at the routers is equal to the total time minus the time at on the wires. How am I going to calculate the time on the wires? That's on the fiber, while it's in the fiber optics rather than actually at the routers. So the time on the wires, well, that's equal to, well, how do we calculate time when we've got distances and speed? Well, it's simply distance divided by speed. Now, what distance are we using? Well, the total time at the routers is equal to total time. Now, that's actually the time for the round trip. So we need to know how long the data is on the fiber optics for the round trip, which means we need to go twice the distance. And that's the one-way distance, twice the one-way distance. And we're going to divide by the speed that the data is travelling in the wires, which is the optical speed. Now, at the moment, we've got, what have we got here? We've got kilometres divided by kilometres per second, which is going to give us an answer in seconds. But our times are measured in milliseconds. So that's seconds at the moment, and we want to convert it into milliseconds. So we have to do it as we have to multiply by the number of milliseconds per second. So that's our conversion factor, which is milliseconds per second. Let's see what happens. 75. Well, that's a bit weird, isn't it? Because the total time was 75. So what's gone wrong? Well, let me just print out here the time on the wires. Zero. Well, that doesn't make sense, does it? Because it's been somewhere, it's come back, it can't have taken zero time. So what's the problem here? Well, the problem is this division. What we have in Python, at least before version 3, is that division is integer division. So if the number is less than one, which it will be here because the one-way distance is only 2,500 and we're dividing by 200,000, Python just rounds it down to the nearest integer, which is zero. So in order to deal with that, I'm just going to make it into a float, which means that it does division normally and gives an answer, which is a decimal. You can convert all of these into floats, but really we just need to do one of them. And if I run it now, I find that the first value here, 25, is the amount of time on the wires, and the total time at routers is 50 milliseconds. So you need to be a little bit careful to make sure that you're doing float division. Float's just a decimal division instead of integer division.